Lidt efter dine ord. Dit job ikke var svært nok.
Hello my friends, welcome back to our channel, and today we're gonna learn equilibrium of bodies. The equilibrium in statics simply means object or particle at rest. It is essential for any structure to be in equilibrium. Think about a bridge. You will not want to pass through a swinging bridge. Then let's start with a mathematical expression and see what it might mean in real life. To have equilibrium, Newton's first law of motion must be satisfied, which is the resultant force must be equal to zero. These are called equilibrium equations. Let us examine crane holding 5 kN object. As you see here, object stays at rest. After that, let's draw a free body diagram of a figure. The force facing upwards is a truss carrying the object, and the force facing downwards is the weight of the object. By the way, free body diagram is a drawing that shows the particle with all forces that act on it, which simplifies our job. It was said that the particle is at rest, so it must satisfy equilibrium condition. We have forces only in y direction, and sum of forces in y direction must be equal to zero. From this equation, we find that truss carries 5 kN. Now, consider this example where a lamp is suspended from 2 diagonal ropes. Drawing free body diagram of it will simplify this figure. F1 and F2 are ropes that hold lamp. We only know the self-weight of the lamp. Can we obtain forces needed for the cables to carry the lamp? By the way, the angle that ropes make with x-axis is 60 degrees. Let me draw free body diagram one more time. First of all, draw the x and y axis and note the positive and negative directions. In our case, it is rightwards for x and upwards for y axis. Always do this or you will end up with the wrong answer. After that, divide F1 and F2 into components. The reason is that they are diagonal, which means they are not parallel to x or y. In this case, they have 2 components, components in x direction and components in y direction. From trigonometry, we know that f1x is equal to f1 times cosine 60, f1y is equal to f1 times sine 60, f2x is equal to f2 times cosine 60, and finally f2y is equal to F2 times sine 60. After dividing into components, we can get rid of F1 and F2. This process also simplifies our free body diagram. Write down the equilibrium equations. First, do it for x direction. We have 2 forces in x direction, F1x and F2x. Because F1 points towards the right direction, we say it is positive. But look at F2. It is facing left direction. Hence, it will be negative. I get from this equation that F1 is equal to F2. Since we don't know F1 and F2, let's skip to the other equation. To this, we will come back later. Then write equilibrium equation for y direction. We have 3 forces in total in y direction. F1y, F2y, and weight of the lamp. F1y and F2y are positive, hence they point upwards. I can write also in this way to get rid of sine 60. Finally, I get sum of F1 and F2 as 11.547 newtons, but I know that F1 is equal to F2 from my first equation. After dividing 11.547 into 2, I get 5.774 newtons. Our final result is like this, where ropes carry 5.774 newton. I can also draw a free body diagram in this way, changing the directions of forces but putting minus sign in front of them. They are both same things, they are equal. Note that you can change direction of any vector if you write negative sign in front of it. But be careful, magnitude of vector should be same, only the direction changes.
Have you ever had a dream that you wanted him to do you so much you could do anything?